And your bride daughter is waiting for you to go into the church.
Oh, the bride. Let me get my flowers. Oh, excuse me.
Is she magnificent?
Michael and Maura are to share in marriage. Let us begin by reminding ourselves that love must be the guiding force in our lives. And let us humbly confess to one another that we have not loved enough. Father, your Son has shown us how to love and invites us to love one another as he loves us. We confess that our lives have not always been a fulfillment of this. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We have been proud and selfish, impatient with others, and all too accommodating to ourselves. We have not trusted enough in your love and in the love of each other. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We have not always been open with each other, afraid to take the chance that in loving we may not be loved in return. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray that the Lord will bless Michael and Maura with happiness and peace. Father, to you alone we look for blessings, in you alone we place all our trust. Look with kindness upon Michael and Maura on this blessed day when they too become one. May you fill their lives with happiness, joy, and peace, and bring them closer to each other and to you in the deepest bonds of human love. We ask you this in the name of Jesus, your Son and our brother, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. It is a thrilling The second reality that all of us have to face, which is like a bookend to the first, is death. Death is a name that we give to the end of life as we see life. And possibly to the eye of the unbeliever, it is the end. But to the eye of a believer, it is but the beginning of what is eternal life. That's how we bookend ourselves. But in the middle, somewhere, we all have to deal with a third mystery, the mystery of falling in love. Fools give you reasons, wise men never try. For those of us who have encountered that, and I hope everybody here at some point has been in love, it is an absolutely wonderful state of life to be in. Now, if I asked you why in the whole of the universe you have found one another, I guess we would have to say that God must go to Cornell alumni reunions, or some angel or somebody, because that, in a way, is the beginning of the milestone of finding one another. Now, it's one thing to find someone. Both of you found lots of other people, right? Maybe some of them are even out here today. If I ask you, though, why would you go that next step, that desire, that willingness, indeed, that you would not even be fulfilled unless you give yourselves one to another. If I ask you to get up here today and explain why you love one another, as I said to you last night, I won't. Don't worry about it. You would be hard-pressed to say exactly why. You know it. You know it intimately. It's internal to you. You both speak a language that none of the rest of us understand. But you have given expression to it in the liturgy that we celebrate today, in the scripture passages that you have chosen, which gives expression to that love, in the music that you've planned, that gives expression to that love. Now, maybe we could have listened to our original parents, our common parents of us all, who tried to give expression to it. This is from Notes on Courtship and Marriage from the Adam and Eve Diaries by Mark Twain. After all these years, this is Adam speaking. After all these years, I see that I was mistaken about Eve in the beginning. It is better to live outside the garden with her than inside it without her. At first, I thought she talked too much, but now I should be sorry to have that voice fall silent and pass out of my life. Eve says, the garden is lost, but I have found him and am content. He loves me as he can. I love him with all the strength of my passionate nature. I suppose that this kind of love is not a product of reasoning and statistics. It just comes, none knows whence, and cannot explain itself and doesn't need to explain itself. Your mere presence here today is the explanation for all of us. And we, all the witnesses to this wedding, and I guess I as the spokesman for all the rest of them, thank you for this privilege to be here, to reaffirm again for us the power of love in our life, in our world, in our need for it. The joy to be able to be here to see this commitment that the two of you make to one another. And never doubt that the love which you share today is the only secret to a life of long happiness together. In hardships and in difficulties, and they will come, as they do to everyone, you will be called upon to show this love in a special and unselfish way. But be assured, just as God was with you in the beginning, He will always be with you, watching over you, caring for you with His tender presence and loving care. The years will go on, but God our Father will always be there, pledging to you His kindness and His care. This is the promise which He makes to you today in the sacrament which you were about to receive. I would ask the congregation to remain seated during the actual marriage ceremony, and I would ask the four. You have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now He enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Michael and Maura, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church.
I, Michael, take you, Maura, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Maura, take you, Michael, to be my husband.
You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessing. What God has joined together, let no person attempt to divide. Lord, bless these rings which we bless in your name. Grant that those who wear them may always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will and always live together in peace, goodwill, and love. We ask you this through Christ our Lord. Maura, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
Maura, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Michael.
Michael.
Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. By the power invested in me by the Roman Catholic Church and by the state of Connecticut, I declare you to be husband and wife. Would the husband like to kiss his wife?
You don't need it in the afternoon. You don't need it in the afternoon. moving forward, using all my breath. Making love to you was never second best. I saw the world crashing all around your face, never really knowing it was always mesh and lace. I'll stop the world and melt with you. You've seen the difference and it's getting better all the time. There's nothing you and I won't do. I'll stop the world and melt with you.
It's a marvelous night for a moon dance, with the stars up above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance, neath the cover of October skies. With all the leaves on the trees are falling, to the sound of the breezes that blow. Yet I'm trying to please to the calling of your heartstrings that play soft and low. Yet all the night magic seem to whisper and hush. Yet all the summer light seems to shine in your blush. Can I just have one more morning dance with you, my love? Can I just make some more romance with you, my love? Well, I wanna make love to you tonight. I can't wait till the morning has come. Yet I know now the time is just right, and straight into my arms you will run. And when you come, my heart will be waiting to make sure that you're never alone. There and then all my dreams will come true, dear. There and then I will make you my own. And every time you just tremble inside. Then I know how much you want me that you can't hide. Can I just have one more moon dance with you, my love? Can I just make some more romance with you, my love? Cover of October skies. All the leaves on the trees are falling to the sound of the breezes that blow. And I'm trying to please to the calling of your heartstrings that play soft and low. In all the night's magic seems to whisper and hush. In all the soft moonlight seems to shine in your blaze. Can I just have one more moon dance with you, oh my love? Or can I just make some more romance with you, oh my love? One more moon dance with you in the moonlight on a magic night. La 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 la.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Jenny Diver, whoa, Suki Tawdry, look out to Miss Lottie Lynn and old Lucy Brown. Yes, that line forms on the right, babe, not that Maggie's back in.